nothing, but I'll have to say again, we have not played all that well, Tommy.
Well, we've had some mistakes in execution and a breakdown in that kicking game as our coverage guys have been giving Hillwood some good field position after we score.
We're looking at third and 20, 2:53 to go in the half, slot left. Triplett takes it, back to pass, long pass to Stone, incomplete. Down on about the 5. That pass, he was trying to hit Damon Stone in the back of the end zone. It got to about the 3, and it was out of bounds, incomplete. And it's 4th and 20. Ball on the 30, 4th down, 20 yards to go.
And I don't think there is a good call, a good play on 4th and 20. I don't know if here comes Zach and Mo Thompson back into the football game. Let's see if a fullback leaves. No, Sellers leaves. So we're going to have Zach lined up outside. Looks like we've got that one back set.
One set back is Rose. Take it. We drop back and we look and we throw deep for the end zone. And it's down there, incomplete. Flag went down in the end zone. That'll be a 15-yard penalty. They were trying to hit Thompson deep, and the flag went down late. And it should go from the 30 to the 15, and it might go with an automatic first down with that. I'm not sure about that. It will not be a first down if it's not an automatic one. Let's check the call. Interference, Hillwood. And I'm not sure, Tommy, or you, is that an automatic first down? If it is... It will be on the 15. If it's not, we're 4th and 5.
I don't think it's an automatic, Bruce. Brent Weatherly was the defensive back in coverage, and look, that is a first down. So first down for the Blue Devils, going to be spotted just outside that 15, maybe call it the 15-yard line, as Weatherly isolated one-on-one with Mo Thompson. When we go to this wide set, the one-back look with three wide receivers and a tight end, everybody's in man coverage, and they've got to try to stop us.
First and 10 on the 15. It was an automatic first. Sweet Neal. Neal's got some daylight. Cuts it out. Cuts it back in. Cuts it to the 5, and there goes another flag down. Well, everybody's throwing flags. One official on one side throwing them, and this one over here, he is really chewed him out pretty heavily during the timeout. And since then, he is calling clips and holds. And he's got another one. So I guess it does do some good sometimes to get on a referee.
Well, especially when he's the one on your side of the field and you're going to have to live with him all night long. You're going to have to live with each other.
That penalty will come all the way back to the 25. This has been a long half, and it's been marred by fumbles and penalties. And we've had the ball most of the last 8 or 9 minutes. And we still haven't scored, and now we're looking at first down, and we've got to go to the 5, I believe. We're on the 25. First and 20 again. We've been in this situation 3 times on this drive. 2:10 to go in the half. Take it, draw play up the middle. Maneer, daylight, 20. Daylight, 15. Go to the 14. Zach Maneer got about 11 yards on that run. On the draw, we spread them out wide and run the draw. 1:53 in the clock running, 2nd down and 9. Zach Maneer carried the ball to the 14. We've got to go to the 5. Lebanon hurries in with a play, 1:38 in the half, 14-0 Blue Devils. Flanker left, split in right, eye set, take it, run a trap to Rose up the middle, another flag down, fumble 2, whistle had already blowed, I think. Man, have they started throwing flags on everybody. Another holding penalty. That is about the 5th holding penalty that we got. That'll wipe out a run that went all the way to the 4-yard line. Rose had run a trap, and they called holding on us again. This is, I think, the 5th holding penalty on this drive. Hillwood, is that an interference call? This has been a pretty sloppy game. John, can you hear me on the field? He may have cut his mic off because we had a lot of interference. I don't think he's picking us up. The referee is going to be tired after this one. He's walking back to the 28-yard line. That penalty, 14 yards. So now it is second and 23. This game has been hard to keep up with.
This drive chart that Terry Stafford's going to compute, we've been up down this field, seems like six or seven times on this one end.
Well, when you come to Nashville, you might as well get ready for it. Spot right. Triplets back to pace, looking for Sellers. He's got him down the sideline. He dropped it down on the 10. Jay Sellers was running a down, out, and up, and a pretty good thrown pass again. Jay had it on about the 9. It went through his hands, incomplete, 3rd and 23. A long drive, 58 seconds. I think in this drive there's been about 8 or 9 flags. One on Hillwood in the end zone on a 4th down and about 5 holding penalties on Lebanon. And we're 3rd and 23. Fake it, hot pass, intercepted. Hillwood on a 15. That pass was intended for Chavez Job. It got tipped, and Hillwood picked it off on the 15, and it was picked off by Kevin Page. Ball will actually be spotted on the 17.
Well, Bruce, first maybe we just needed a change of scenery with being down there on offense. This seems like this entire second quarter is with 44 seconds and the clock running. Hillwood finally gets the football back deep in their own territory.
I don't think they was going to ever let us score, so we might as well let them have it. First and 10. Gallagher takes it and falls down and takes a knee, and we hit him after he took a knee. Let's see if there's a flag on this one. There is not. I don't think they'll run another play. Gallagher wants a penalty. He won't get it, but he does get a pat by the referee. 12 seconds. This half is going to end. End of the first half. The score, 11 14, Hillwood 0. We'll take a 2-minute break.
And this thing straightened out on field because it's been a real sloppy first half. We're lucky to get out of here 14 to nothing. Hoping things get better. We're leading 14 to nothing. Pressure to the kickoff. He comes forward and kicks it, and he kicks it out of bounds. Flag goes down. Two flags go down, but it went out of bounds. I think they have their choice to bring it out to the 35. Let's see if they do. Or they can choose to let Levin kick it over. They're going to talk to the captain of Hillwood. And I'm not sure what they're going to do. I think they're going to let Levin kick it over. No, they're not. They're going to take it on the 35-yard line, first down and 10. Hillwood defense comes on the field for Lebanon. So, Lebanon 14, Hillwood 0 from the Belmead area, somewhere in Nashville. And almost right in the middle of a subdivision. Hillwood with the ball. Gallagher split back there. Takes the ball, runs a dive, bang, hit, knocked down, and we really hit him, or Marlo C. really hit him. No gain, might have lost a yard. He did.
Marlo and Alex Skullrood right in the hole, and nothing on that play.
We might be better just to let them run and us stay on defense, the way the flags have been flying. We're in the second half. We just started. We split a man right out here to the right. Two tight ends and an eye set. Gallagher, long count, takes it, runs a dive option, pitches it. Got a little round fumble of ball, but he fell on it on the 35. A bad pitch was behind him. Dillon picked it up back on the 35 and got a yard out of it as he rolled it up to the 35. They'll put it actually now on the 36 if they ever set it down.
Bruce, a little defensive changeup as the Blue Devils have moved Cantrell to a defensive tackle spot. And in at nose guard for Lebanon High School, Corey Deppendahl to start the second half.
Ball on a 36. Third and 9. Two wide outs to the left. Gallagher back to pace. Looking, here comes a stump. We're after him. He throws it in a flat and we knock him down for a 6 or 7 yard loss. Skullrood hitting
We were chasing Gallagher, and Skullrude played that just the way you're supposed to. He had the flat. When the man crossed his face, he covered him and knocked him down back on the 27.
And Bruce Skullrude never got too much depth. He played it flat down the line of scrimmage, pursued, broke on the football when he had to, in perfect position on that play. In the punt is Jay Robinson.
That lost 8 yards. They got the punt. Robinson is the punter. Devon's standing on the 44. He punts it, shanked it up in the air, and we need to get away from it. Mo Thompson calls for a catch, and they hit him. They hit him after he caught it, but they will keep their flag in their pocket. They really didn't hit him that hard, I guess. Ball on the 49 in Hillwood territory. Terry, not much of a kick.
From the 27, Bruce, 11 to take over to Hillwood 49, a 22-yard punt, no return.
So Mo Thompson called a fair catch. He got bumped a little bit after he caught it, but not enough. Maybe they've told him to hold the flags in your pocket. I hope so. Come out of the huddle, 11 minutes on Hillwood's 49. We're leading 14 to nothing. Take it, and we run it off left tackle. And Zach broke outside of the 45 and carried somebody with him to the 41. We're shooting that thing off left tackle or right tackle, and then we're seeing daylight to the outside, and Zach seen it and got to the 40. Actually, they say his knee touched on the 42. Got 7. Second and 3. Thompson in with a play. DeMont goes out. Second down and 3. The ball on the 42. It's barely inside of the 42. Slot left. Trippett takes it. Runs the fullback. Rose trapped up the middle and got a first down. And broke off one man and broke off another and got to the 34 and got knocked down. So if we can keep away from the holding and just run and stick another one in here, we've got 14-0 lead. And Rose run the trap that time. And we trapped him and got to the 33 and got a first down.
Steve Rose, like a bull in a china shop, once he broke the line of scrimmage, it, one or two people just have not been able to bring him down. It took a whole host, 5 or 6 of those green-jerseyed Hillwood tacklers to get that momentum stopped.
Slot left, sweet right. There goes Maneer, cutting it in, cuts it in for 5, and look at the flags fly. Well, we gained 20, but you can wipe it out. They've called another flag. Flag downfield is on the 20. We had picked up about 20 on the play all the way down to the 9-yard line somewhere. But that will be wiped out as another holding penalty has been stepped off. That is penalty number 7 for the Blue Devils. And all of them have been major penalties. That was a clip. And now I think we have got another penalty. Maybe on DeMond Stone, unsportsmanlike conduct. The referee threw a flag, and now we're going to get a 30-yard penalty. 15 more added to that. This is ridiculous. 30-yard penalty, 15 for clipping. And this thing, that is 8 penalties. I don't see how you can come down here and play.
They can't believe the call on that one. Sellers looked like he just fell down, and they called him for a clip. Back up to you.
We are watching it up here, John. We take it. We're running in the flat to Sellers. He caught it. Broke it at the 40, 45, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. There is no flags, and Sellers has got 6. No flags, I don't think. I'm going to watch the flags. No flags. There are no flags. There is not a penalty on that play.
Jade Sellers,
or not.
Jade Sellers broke in the open after he breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage.